Hello everyone, welcome to Medicapel. Our Introduction to ECG Part 1 inch video is here. What is ECG? ECG, or electrocardiography, is the recording of electrical activities occurring in the heart in order to examine the functioning of the heart muscle and neural conduction system. Anatomical location of the heart. Our heart is located in the chest cavity, between the two lungs, behind the sternum, on the diaphragm muscle and on the back surface of the fourth, fifth and sixth ribs, two-thirds to the left of the midline. ECG paper trays and recording. ECG paper is also called trace. There are large squares on the trace and five rows of vertical and five rows of small horizontal squares formed by them. A standard ECG recording should be taken at a speed of 25 mm sec and a voltage of 10 mm mV. To check these standards, we can check the explanations at the bottom of the ECG trace. Trace times. Small squares are 1 mm in size horizontally and vertically. For an ECG taken at 10 mm 1 mV, one small vertical square is worth 0.1 mV. Millivolt is the value that shows the electrical intensity of voltage pulse waves. This value is used to evaluate ECG waves in many disorders, especially myocardial infarction. The small squares show the time horizontally. Important note: one small square equals 0.04 seconds of time horizontally. Therefore, one large square consisting of five small squares is equal to 0.20 seconds. These values are used primarily for rate calculation. Electrolyte disorders, ventricular arrhythmias, etc. It is used in all rhythm evaluations. Electrodes and derivations. Electrodes and cables contact the patient and transfer electrical activity to the ECG device. Leads are the reflections on the ECG paper of the electrical activity recorded by the electrodes placed on the patient. Leads are like cameras that see the heart from different angles. Derivations and neighborhood relationships. Derivations are divided into two: extremity derivations and chest precordial derivations. Extremity leads are leads taken by contact of electrodes to the patient's wrists and ankles. Electrodes should be placed as red on the right arm, yellow on the left arm, black on the right leg and green on the left leg. If the patient's extremity is amputated, it can be placed in the area closest to the extremity. 6-lead ECG. The red, yellow and green leads attached to the patient are called bipolar leads. Bipolar derivations, there are three: lead 1D1, lead to D2 and lead 3. The black electrode attached to the patient's right foot shows unipolar leads. Unipolar leads, there are three: AVR, AVL, AVF. Therefore, if we connect the red, yellow and green electrons to the patient, we will have a 3-lead ECG. And if we connect the black electrode on the right leg, we will have a 6-lead ECG. Chest derivations, precordials, and 12-lead EC. Six electrodes attached to the patient's chest form precordial leads, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, and V6. All extremity and chest leads constitute the 12-lead ECG. Reflections of the derivations. Bipolar leads in the ECG reflect electrical activity. Lead 1 from the right arm to the left arm. Lead 2 from the right arm to the left leg. Lead 3 from the left arm to the left leg. Unipolar leads are amplified reflections created by the black electrode connected to the right leg. AVR reflects the amplified electrical activity of the right arm. AVL reflects the amplified electrical activity of the left arm. AVF reflects enhanced electrical activity of the left leg. Neighborhood relationships of derivations. There are neighborly relations between derivations. In order for the evaluation made on the ECG to be considered correct, the same finding must be observed in at least two of the adjacent leads. Neighborhood relationships of derivations. D1, high lateral. AVL, high lateral. D2, inferior. D3, inferior. AVF shows the inferior derivations. AVL with D1 shows high lateral. We can remember this from the letter L at the end of AVL and the initials of the letter L in the ascending lateral. D2, D3 and AVF represent the inferior derivation. We can remember this from the letter F in AVF and the letter F in inferior. The AVR derivation does not have a neighborhood relationship with any other derivation. We will also explain the evaluation of the AVR derivation in our introduction to ECG part 2 video. Neighborhood relations in the precordials are V1 septal, V2 septal, V3 anterior, V4 anterior, V5 lateral, V6 lateral. V1 and V2 represent the septal derivation. V3 and V4 represent the anterior derivation. And V5 and V6 represent the lateral derivation. We can abbreviate the neighborhood relations of the precordials as SAL from the initials. The similarity of names of the higher lateral and lateral derivations should not mislead us. Although both of them have the name lateral, they cannot be evaluated by mixing them with each other in neighborly relations. Conduction system of the heart. The conduction system of the heart is examined under three main headings. Sinoatrial assay node. Atrioventricular AV node. Bundle of his right and left branches and Purkinje fibers. Sinoatrial assay node. It is located in the upper posterior part of the right atrium. It is the natural pacemaker of the heart. It generates between 60 and 100 alerts per minute. It can generate up to a maximum of 150 alerts in abnormal situations. Atrioventricular AV node. The stimulus from the sinoatrial mode spreads to the atria, then reaches the AV node. The stimulus, kept here for a short time, is transmitted to the ventricle. His bundle, branches, and Purkinje fibers. The stimulus from the AV node is transmitted to the His bundle greater than right and left branch greater than Purkinje fibers in the ventricles, respectively. Egg waves. Isoelectric line. The horizontal line between two heartbeats that shows the time when there is no electrical activity is called isoelectric line. Pulses above the isoelectric line are called positive pulses. Pulses below the isoelectric line are called negative pulses. P wave. It is the first positive wave of a heartbeat. Atrial depolarization appears as a P wave on the ECG. The morphology structure of the P wave should be 0.25 mV, that is, 2.5 small squares, vertically, and 0.12 seconds, that is, less than 3 small squares, horizontally. If the morphology of the P wave is normal, it indicates that the stimulus is coming from the sinoatrial SA node, that is, it is sinus rhythm. If its morphology is distorted, it indicates that the stimulus is coming from a focus in the atrium, not the SA node, that is, it is atrial or there is a problem in the atria. Let's examine. PR interval. The stimulus coming out of the sinoatrial mode depolarizes the atria and reaches the atrioventricular AV node. After the message is kept in the AV node for a short time, it is transmitted to the ventricles. The time between the stimulus leaving the sinoatrial SA node and being transmitted to the ventricle is evaluated as the PR interval on the ECG. PR interval, it is the part from the beginning of the P wave to the beginning of the QRS complex. Its duration is minimum 3 and maximum 5 small squares. That is, 0.1 to 0.20 seconds. A PR interval above 0.20 seconds indicates a problem with the AV node. PR interval below 0.12 seconds is called pre-excitation syndrome. Let's examine. PR segment. The part from the end of the P wave to the first wave of the QRS is called the PR segment. The PR segment must be at the same level as the isoelectric line. Changes in the PR segment occur due to pericarditis or atrial ischemia. QRS complex. The QRS complex is formed by transmitting the stimulus from the AV node to the bundle of His, branches, and Purkinje fibers, respectively. The QRS complex indicates ventricular depolarization. QRS complex is formed by the combination of QRS waves. It is considered normal for the QRS complex to last a maximum of 0.12 seconds, that is, 3 small squares. If the QRS complex is wider than 3 small squares, it indicates that the stimulus is a ventricular rhythm. The common feature of all ventricular rhythms is that they have wide QRS. It does not matter how narrow the QRS is, and it can be negative or positive depending on the leads. Let's examine. Wide QRS. ST segment. The street segment is the part from the end of the QRS complex to the beginning of the T wave. ST segment. At the end of the S wave, a break called J point occurs and the saint segment starts from here. J point. The street segment should be on the isoelectric line. The street segment being above the isoelectric line is called elevation, and being below it is called depression. The absence of the saint segment in the isoelectric line indicates that there may be damage to the heart muscle and an evaluation for acute coronary syndrome is required. Let's examine. T-wave. The ventricles, which are depolarized by the QRS complex, then contract and pump blood to the body. Ventricular repolarization is examined as a T-wave on the ECG. The amputation of the T-wave, that is, its voltage, should be less than 5 mm in the extremity leads and less than 15 mm in the precordials. Its width should be shorter than 6 mm in the extremity leads and less than 10 mm in the precordial leads. Changes in the voltage or width of the T-wave suggest electrolyte disturbances, and if it is negative outside the V1 lead, it suggests myocardial damage. Let's examine. KT interval. KT duration is the time from the beginning of the Q wave to the end of the T wave. QT duration should not be shorter than 0.36 sec than 9 small squares and should not be longer than 0.4 for sec than 2 small squares. QT prolongation, it is the ECG symptom of disorders such as hypokalemia, hypocalcemia, hypomagnesemia, IBPS, post-cardiac arrest, or congenital long QT syndrome. Short QT interval can be seen due to hypercalcemia, digoxin use, and in cases of congenital short QT syndrome. You can access the rest of our video from our ECG reading part to video on the top right, and you can subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications to be informed about our other videos. See you in another video. Goodbye. Prepared and performed by lecturer Fatih Salim Elmah.